I'm not sure if this is recording. Oh,
it's about to start.
Yay.
Long time in the making, this one. We've had illnesses. We've had stuff just get in the way. But here we finally are.
Glad you're here.
I'm glad to be here. This is, for those of you watching, a champion versus champion match. The anti-feminist and I were two of the winners of the last round of debate tournaments. I won the Steel Man debate. And which one was it you won? Was it social issues or was it political?
I guess it was political because I debated the one I won on was the travel ban. So I'm guessing it was political.
Yeah, it sounds political. The proposition that my opponent has put forward tonight is feminism is an ideology that is harmful to our society. So I will give you the floor for however long you need to make your prime case, and then we'll get into the meat of things.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. Thank you for being here, and anybody who's watching, thank you for watching. I feel like my name being the anti-feminist, most people know that I'm not for feminism. I'm not a feminist myself. I'm an egalitarian. And an egalitarian is somebody who thinks that all people deserve equal rights and equal standing in society, and that nobody should be treated differently than anyone else because of anything, whether it be their gender or their race or their religion or any of those things. So with that being said, feminism itself relies on the patriarchy, which is something that we don't live in at least in America. It's not something that, and that's usually the country I argue from. And feminism is an idea that I'm going to quote the amazing atheist and say that feminism is the idea that both sexes can be equal by focusing solely on the issues of one of them. And that's essentially what feminism is. It's saying, you know, we want to focus on women, and men are the problem with everything. And when it comes to rape, when it comes to women getting paid less, when it comes to women not taking as many jobs, women not being in Congress as much, all of those things are because of men and because of the patriarchy, which again doesn't exist in our country. Feminism is something that it creates itself as saying all we're about is equality. All we want is just equality. But really, the kind of equality they want is important. The kind of equality feminists want is the equality of outcome and not the equality of opportunity. Feminists already have the equality of opportunity. Women are graduating more with every single degree, from bachelor's, associate's, doctorate, master's. Women graduate more from college. Women get accepted to college more. There's more scholarships for women. and all of the different factors that make life difficult, such as and all the different threats out there, such as homelessness, sexual assault. Well, sexual assault I wouldn't be willing to necessarily go into in this debate, but let's say murder, homelessness, marriage equality, as far as equality of kids, where, you know, who gets the kids at the end of a divorce, all of those things favor women. And we live in a society that spends all of its time really trying to help women. In the early 1900s, women only lived 1 or 2 years longer than men. Now they live 7 or 8 years longer than men. Men have done so much in our society to help women and to benefit women while keeping themselves enslaved. And where we reached a point in our society where women now have a choice to work full-time, work part-time, stay home with the kids if they want to, and be a full-time parent, be a part-time parent. Whereas I think it was Tim Allen who said, you know, men essentially have the choice between work and prison. And those are the only job opportunities we have left. Women will fight for equality when it is convenient for them. But feminists essentially want to have all of the benefits of equality without any of the responsibilities of equality. For instance, the draft. That's something that feminists have been wanting to be able to be in the infantry for, I don't know exactly how long, but that's been a big topic of conversation. So feminists want to be in the infantry, but they refuse to fight for the draft. They don't want to be drafted because who would? That's not something anybody really wants to fight for, but that's the whole reason men got the vote originally, was because they were conscripted to die. I think my main point is, again, just that feminists want equality of outcome and not equality of opportunity. And that's my main point. So I do much better rebutting stuff, so I'm just going to go ahead and pass the mic.
Well, rebutting is really the easier part of this. So let's start with your base premise, which is egalitarianism versus feminism. Now, you are talking a lot in the present tense. The thing is that we don't live just in the present tense. We have a history in this country and globally. Feminism was only really something that started in that they only started using that term in the 1960s. But even before then, you had forms of feminism. Let's start by talking about the vote. You're simply just plain wrong that men got the vote because of the draft, because not all men who were draftable had the vote when this country started. It was a state-by-state issue because there's no federal constitutional right to vote, or there wasn't originally. Now there's one for Senate. But it was a state-by-state issue, and for the most part, it was only land-owning males of a certain age who had the vote. And by land-owning males, that usually meant white males. You didn't own land. It didn't matter if you were a man or a woman. So the vote was denied to women for no other reason than that they were women. It wasn't connected to any additional social responsibility that men took on. Furthermore, while women haven't been in the infantry, women have had roles in our wars for basically the entire history of the country, not to mention most of the history of man. Usually they were not particularly glamorous roles, things like camp women.
And they weren't risky roles.
Well, you're still on the front lines. Plus, you had women in medicine.
No, they were not on the front lines.
Name some
positions that women fought on the front lines.
Mostly in medicine. You have to be close enough to the wounded people to treat them, and that puts you within range.
They had camps. That's not the same as the front. Don't compare the front lines to camps that are safe. That's not even close.
What?
That's insulting to infantry and cavalry.
Do you understand where a camp was located in most of the history of war in the United States? You couldn't have a camp that was, you know, dozens of miles away from the main fighting, because then how are you going to get the wounded back and forth?
No, but that's not, I'm not saying that it wasn't close to the front line. I'm just saying that it was the front line is disingenuous. So let's be honest here. They weren't on the front lines. They were in tents and they were in safe areas. They weren't on the front lines risking their life. They were risking their life in the sense they were participating in a war, but they weren't risking their life in the sense that they weren't under gunfire constantly.
I'm interested where you believe you can find a cannonball-proof tent. Let's talk about that after the debate. I think your statement kind of speaks for itself. People can judge the credibility. But we're getting away from your root accusation, which was that men having the vote was somehow connected to the draft or to military service.
No, my root accusation, again, the premise that feminists want equality of outcome and not equality of opportunity. You're focusing on, and I'll concede the point. I'll just say, oh, you're right. You're right. That wasn't the reason that they were given the vote. I'd like to know why you think that feminism is something that is useful in our society as of now. I don't necessarily need to talk about the past, because the past is the past and the present is the present. So let's focus on right now. Why do feminists need to have, or why do we need feminists right now? Why is it relevant when we have egalitarianism?
First of all, at the very least, we need feminism as an academic study, because yes, the history is relevant. It matters that 4 or 5 decades ago in this country, women didn't have anywhere near the same opportunities that they do today. That historical perspective matters. The same way that it matters for understanding of race, understanding of immigrant issues, same way it matters for understanding why I, as a child,
women were a lot happier, but yeah, they were happier in their role.
There's no objective way to measure that, for one thing.
Yes, there is. And I'd like to cite the study. Yeah, I'd like to cite the study, The Paradox of Declining Female Happiness. So if you want to look up that study and see that females are actually less happy now that they have more responsibility, that's actually, you know, unfortunately true, that women, as they've been given more and more responsibilities and more opportunities, they become less and less happy, because I guess they don't like responsibility.
Okay.
And it was easier to be a housewife than it is to be a breadwinner.
All right. Well, let's address this historical perspective. You're actually making a good case for why feminism and women's studies is important, because your premise, would you please stop interrupting me? I gave you a full 5 minutes to say your piece, and so far I haven't gotten more than 30 seconds straight without being interrupted, okay? So let's go back to this idea of women as housewives. this is a part of a uniquely 1950s American narrative that simply hasn't matched the reality for women for most of time. Women have always worked. They've always been barmaids. They've always been farmers. They've always been gatherers. They've always been cooks. They've always done things. In much of history, most of the work that both men and women were doing was within the household. Men were the hunters and the farmers. Women were the clothiers and the cooks and took care of the children while the men went out and did stuff in the fields. So this, you're relying on a narrative about women and about feminism that is based on, I suppose, your viewing of several episodes of Leave It to Beaver. It hasn't been the truth of the history in America. In fact,
nice straw man.
You're the one with the straw man here. You're citing the 1950s housewife or women just staying.
You're using red herrings to prove your argument. I'm not straw manning anyone. I'm saying that feminism, you're talking about what women have dealt with. That has nothing to do with feminism.
It has everything.
Feminism itself is a toxic. No, because feminism itself is a toxic ideology. You can have women suffering and women having not equal opportunities without feminism. Feminism doesn't need to exist in order for us to acknowledge that women had it worse in some ways than men did.
All right.
But in the same sense, women had it better than men did. They had more security than men did. They got more, they had a lot more security than men did in the sense that if something happened in our society as far as them getting divorced, we still took care of them. And throughout history, for the most part, our societies have tried to, at least when we've been enlightened, have tried to take care of women more than men, whereas men have just been cannon fodder.
Okay. I'm going to respectfully, for the moment, ignore everything that you just said and get back to what I was going to talk about, which is the 14th Amendment to the Constitution. 14th Amendment to the Constitution was ratified in, I believe, the 1870s was when it was finally ratified by enough states. And it provided that all citizens had to be equal or were supposed to be equal under the law. They were supposed to have what you talked about, equal opportunity. Well, it took 50 more years and a completely separate constitutional amendment for women to get the right to vote. It took another 50 years for women to be allowed into most universities, into most schools of higher education. It wasn't until 7 years after the 14th Amendment was ratified or so when the first woman was elected to Congress. During all of that time, you had these women who were practicing what we now call feminism because, yeah, the law on the books might have said they were supposed to be equal, but that was not enough to sustain their equality. Now, This is still the case today. Women, yes, still are closer to equality in America,
they have more equality.
But around the world, most women are still living in non-egalitarian situations, and it's women in countries like the United States and in the Western European democracies who continue to promulgate the idea of feminism that are helping those women move closer towards equality. So you're talking about your experience in the United States in 2017. That is an extraordinarily limited window from which to say that feminism, on the whole, as it has existed for the past six decades, as it existed before that in the form of the suffragettes, to say that that's harmful to our society today, based only on your very limited experience, is far too limiting. In terms of what you're saying about harm versus benefit and what you're saying about our society. You're isolating our society
to
the moment.
You're not discussing feminism, though. All you're talking about is you're essentially throwing out a ton of red herrings. You're not discussing feminism. You're discussing what women faced. So let's talk about feminism instead of talking about all the red herrings that you're throwing
out. I'm not throwing out red herrings.
Red herrings. Yeah,
The definition of feminism.
And you're straw manning.
The definition of feminism is the advocacy of women's rights on the basis of equality of the sexes. You're right that feminism in particular focuses on the inequalities suffered by women, but it's still a fundamental
egalitarian. It also relies on the patriarchy, which doesn't exist in our country.
Okay.
And never
How
did.
How many women presidents have we had?
That's not a sign of the patriarchy.
How many women presidents have we had?
I'm not answering your question because it's not relevant to the subject.
It's not relevant to the subject that the most important position in our country has never been occupied by a woman, and patriarchy doesn't exist.
Have women been able to be president?
Not so far.
Have women had? They haven't been able to. So up until now, 2017, women have never been. Hillary Clinton was running for president, wasn't she? Wasn't she the Democratic primary?
She was running for it.
Didn't she lose?
Exactly.
Okay, she lost, didn't she? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, she lost because she wasn't inept. She was a completely inept person, and she wasn't able to get elected. So that's the fault of sexism, and not the fact that she was a deplorable person who had a rapist as a husband.
Well, you see right there, you want to talk about egalitarianism, and here you are blaming a wife for her husband's infidelities.
Well, she actually helped antagonize his victims. So yeah, I think that she plays a part in it, and she stayed married to him while he got a blowjob in the Oval Office. So yeah, she doesn't sound like she cares about anything but power. And the people that I know that have personally like worked around her through Secret Service said she's an absolute scumbag that doesn't care about anybody or herself. So yeah, you can, you know, think what you want, but again, answer my question. Have women had the opportunity to run for office?
Not for more than half the history of our country, no. It required feminism to
Let's talk about now. Do women have the ability to run for office?
In the United States, yes. In most of the world, still
okay.
No.
So they are able to run for office. They are able to run for the presidency. We know because of Hillary Clinton that they are. And just because they don't see, this is why I say feminism cares about equality of outcome and not equality of opportunity. Feminists, or rather women in general, have the opportunity to become president. That doesn't mean that they're guaranteed the outcome of becoming president. And the dangers of feminism is that people like yourself, it seems, want to see inequality of outcome and not inequality of opportunity, which is not how the world works. So should a man who can carry two bricks in his wheelbarrow be paid, or should a woman who can only carry one brick in her wheelbarrow be paid the same amount as a man who can carry two?
I don't know exactly what jobs you're thinking of, or wheelbarrow, or there's bricks.
This is a hypothetical question.
It's a dumb question.
Should a woman,
you're talking about red herring. Okay. You're throwing
should
out
a woman,
this nonsense.
Should a woman who can carry one brick in a wheelbarrow be paid the same amount as a man who can carry two?
The answer to your question will be the same as the answer to this question. Should you be paid less than me just because I can carry more bricks?
Yes. If you're a harder worker and you can produce more results, then yes, I should be paid less than you.
Okay. Should a woman who, what do you do for a living?
I worked with disabled adults. I'm not going to discuss what I do right now, but I worked with disabled adults.
Yeah, there's limits to what you can say there. So let's just say nursing. Should a woman who is able to work longer hours than a man be paid the same as that man as a male nurse, even if he is able to do different tasks while he is on the job?
Okay, well, objectively, women work less hours than men do, which is why
that's an aggregate figure, and that has nothing to do with
it. No, it's not. I can supply objective figures, multiple different ones, if you'd like, at the end of
this.
That's
an aggregate figure.
But women objectively work less hours than men
do. Okay, why?
So
why do women work fewer hours? Why are they not?
Because they're lazy.
Oh, wow. Well,
not all of them. I'm not generalizing here.
Dude, what the heck? You just said all women are lazier than men. You are generalizing.
Did I say that? Did I say all women?
Women are lazy.
Did I say
that? That was the sentence that you stated. Women are lazy.
You asked why.
This is horrible.
You asked why do they work less hours? And I said, because they're lazy. I didn't say all women. You're putting words in my mouth, and I don't appreciate all the straw man, but again,
using that term, I don't think it means
because you're straw manning me by saying something I never said.
Well, that's
the definition of a straw man. You know what a logical fallacy is?
No, the definition of a straw man is when you build up an idea that is easily attackable and attack that instead of the real thing, which is what you are doing.
That's what you've been doing this whole time.
No, that's what you're doing when you call feminism this very specific myopic thing that you want it to be.
I'm saying feminism at its root wants equality of opportunity and not equality of outcome. Feminists want to get the same outcome as men without doing the same work.
No.
So women work less hours. Women work less hours. Women work,
not all women.
Less holidays. Well, all the studies that have come out show that they work less hours. So all the studies that I can cite, which maybe a dozen, are all saying that they work less hours. So
in the aggregate.
Again, women also work more part-time jobs instead of full-time jobs. Women also work easier jobs, such as secretary and things. They also work less dangerous jobs. So women as a whole, work less hours, work less full-time, more part-time, take more time off work, stay home with the kids more often than men do, and work less dangerous jobs. And yet they still demand to have the same outcome as men who work more dangerous jobs, longer hours, more full-time, don't get maternity leave, don't get any time with their kids for the most part, false. And are essentially working themselves. I'm talking about objective facts here, but you can disagree with it
all. Men have the same right to leave under the Family Medical Leave Act that women do. I know it because I have two kids. And women don't really, you want to talk about an issue that shows where feminism is valuable. The United States is the only country in the world without any sort of paid maternity leave. And it shows in the progress of our children educationally, nutritionally, and health-wise.
I agree. Now, I agree with that. But that doesn't need feminism. That just needs egalitarianism or anything else. It doesn't need feminism. Feminism is irrelevant to that.
But it's not, because it's a situation where women are at a disadvantage here versus everywhere else.
So why is egalitarianism not okay to tackle
feminism?
That? Why do you need
because
feminism?
Of you? Because of people like you who claim egalitarianism doesn't mean we address women specific issues.
No, it does actually. By definition, it says that all people, instead of creating these small little cliques like you apparently want, is to have an entire group of people.
51%. It's 53 where I live, but yeah, more than half the population. You're saying that's a little clique group. That's half the country.
No,
man.
I'm saying that you want to have essentially a group focusing on one group of people, and there's people who want to focus on Black rights. Mm-hmm. There's people who want to focus on gay rights, transgender rights, all those different things, which are creating these more and more divisive circles of women, men, Black, white, gay, straight, transgender, whatever.
Whereas egalitarianism
sees all people as people. So I don't see people as women, men, Black, white, Islam, Jewish. I don't see that. You do. You see race. You see gender. I don't. What I see is people who have less equality than others. And in our country, speaking about America, men have it objectively worse in nearly every single facet than women do. And so to talk to somebody who says, oh, well, I think we need feminism. I think we need to focus on women's issues. Women's issues have been focused on for at least the last 100 years nonstop, to the point where men's issues are being so drowned out that no one can even talk about them without being ostracized. So men have it objectively worse in our country. And again, nearly every facet, men die from every preventable disease besides breast cancer more often. They commit suicide more. They're homeless more. I mean, they lose their children in custody battles more. You name it, men suffer from it more. So again, I'd like to understand why feminism is relevant when women have it so much better than men do in our society.
Well, let's roll back to the beginning of that rant. It is your choice to feel divided from people who choose to work for issues specific to their group or a group close to their hearts.
What about men dying earlier? Men That's dying fine. From more preventable diseases.
That's fine. You go out and you fight for men's rights. You can do that. In fact, I have a friend right now who is a self-identified feminist who is also a men's rights activist and will take the father's side just about in every issue when you talk about children's rights in a divorce. You don't have...
Then he's not a feminist.
She's a she.
Okay, then she's not a feminist.
But she is, because she also cares about areas where women are disadvantaged. What you're basically saying...
Name an area where women are disadvantaged in America. Name one area.
Women are still paid less for the same work at the same hours.
No, they're not. That is such bullshit.
No,
they're
not. Specifically in the area of law.
There's a book called Why Men Earn More and What Women Can Do About It. I suggest you read it because it's a really good book that explains that women do not earn less. And that is a bullshit statistic that has been puppeted by feminists who do not do their own research for years and years and years.
Okay.
Let me finish. When you compare for education, experience, hours worked, and all the other variables are off. Women earn more. Women earn significantly more than men in most of the cities in the United States, like New York and San Francisco. Women earn more. Wait.
Are you now limiting your argument to major urban areas?
I'm saying that if you look at most of the major cities in our country.
Okay, so you are limiting it to major cities. You're aware.
I'm saying that women earn more in the major cities. I'm saying that there's a federal law that says they have to be paid equally. So, you know, you can't pull that bullshit. But
well, I have a friend.
Women do not.
I have a friend works for the NLRB that has to try to enforce that law, and their employer is trying to skirt it all the time. Again, why we need feminism?
Well, they're committing a federal crime if that's true. Fortunately, there's a federal law that says they can't do that.
Yeah. And so, like I said earlier with the 14th Amendment, just because you pass a law doesn't mean you don't need advocates. Since the 14th Amendment has been passed, it's been litigated hundreds, if not thousands of times before the Supreme Court to make the government actually enforce it.
Okay, well, unfortunately, your argument is just total moot. And like I said, I'd suggest reading a book on it because you do not know what you're talking about if you honestly think women earn 78 cents or whatever statistic you're going to try to throw at me. When you consider all the variables, like I said, experience, time worked, education, and all those different things, time off, all that, women earn more on average than men do. But women also work less dangerous jobs, less hours, and all those things. So those are the important things, is women, you know, choose to work jobs that pay less. The statistics that tell us that women earn less are when you compare all of men's salaries to all of women's salaries, which is a useless statistic. If you compare all of one thing to all of another without...
You're confounding your statistics. You're confounding your statistics because you're doing the same thing.
Again, I suggest you read a book by Warren Farrell, who was a feminist and head of the National Women's Organization for 3 years, something no other man has ever held. And his book says that you're full of shit. So I would suggest reading his book, who, again, head of the National Women's Organization for 3 years. I'd suggest reading his book because he was fighting for feminism back when it was actually a cause that some people could still objectively say we still need it. But at this point, again, feminism relies on the patriarchy. We don't live in a patriarchy. Therefore, by definition, feminism is absolutely useless.
Yeah, but again, your entire argument limits feminism to your experience in the United States of America in 2007.
No, this is by definition.
That's what you keep coming back to.
Feminism relies on the patriarchy.
It's not important anymore.
We don't live in a patriarchy.
It doesn't rely on a patriarchy. It's an egalitarian. No,
it's
an egalitarian principle. Yeah, we did live in a patriarchy.
Don't shit on egalitarianism by comparing it to feminism. That's insulting.
Well, it's interesting that when you talk about egalitarianism, you seem to be very specifically concerned about the problems of a straight white male, and you want to poo-poo.
Actually, no, I haven't. Straw man.
Earlier,
I haven't talked
earlier
about
you said people are causing divisions from what you want
by
fighting for African-American rights, LGBT rights, women's rights. That's nonsense. The fact that other people are fighting for their own rights. The fact that other people are fighting for their own rights doesn't prejudice your rights. It doesn't prejudice your ability to fight for your rights.
I never said it did, but you can keep strawmanning me all you want.
You called it divisive. You are the one who are choosing to be divided.
Yeah, it is divisive. It is divisive, just like Black Lives Matter is divisive.
No, it's not.
Okay. Well, your ignorance is your bliss, I guess. But that doesn't mean for us who are looking at it objectively and informed that's not how it is.
You can throw out words like objectively and informed all you want, but the thing is, the opposite of Black Lives Matter is not all lives matter. It's Black Lives Don't Matter. The opposite of feminism is misogyny. You're trying to say feminism and egalitarianism are different things when they're rooted in the same fundamental principle.
Your grip, if that's honestly what you think about those words, then your grip on the English language is tenuous.
It's in the Merriam-Webster
dictionary.
Because that's
not how words work.
It's in the Merriam-Webster dictionary. The feminism
is... Congratulations. So is meh.
Yeah. And meh has a...
That doesn't mean that the definition is 100% accurate. Just because the definition says one thing does not mean that the people who are puppeting these facts and these bullshit, like you said, about women earning less, which is objectively false by even feminists like Christina Hoff Sommers. I mean, you are puppeting facts that even feminists disagree with. As if they're true and relevant when they're not. And it's harmful to our society because, yeah, it does create a divisive culture when people say women earn less when they earn more.
They don't earn more. They don't.
Yes,
they don't do. Anymore in my profession.
I will be happy to post sources after this discussion because you are just wrong and objectively
on,
so.
On complete average. You bring up the 78 cents on the dollar. That's the statistic that doesn't take into account education type of job hours worked. The studies that look at specific professions find that women earn less than men for the same work at the same education level working the same hours. That's just-
I'm looking forward to posting the statistics showing you're full of shit, but you can keep saying it.
I made a... I'll probably just let my feminist friends outsource that because it's probably not worth
it. That's fine. You can keep saying stuff that doesn't make it true.
Let's get back to your initial screed because there's so much of it that we haven't gotten to. So
yeah, let's focus on feminism instead of just the red herrings. Let's try and focus on how feminism is not harmful to our society.
We've been focusing on feminism. Let's take this as something.
What is one thing that women suffer from more of than men? You said one bullshit thing about the pay gap, which doesn't exist. So how about something that's actually true, or something that you just think is true? I'm happy to throw down more things.
Well,
that
the pay thing is true, but let's look at other.
It isn't.
It is.
But again, Warren Farrell's book, Why Men
Earn More and What We Do About It,
is a great book.
Funny how you never.
Yeah, he was a feminist for longer than.
So let's go back to something else ridiculous that you said. You say men are keeping themselves.
I'd like to hear another way in our society where women suffer more than men because
women are by far more frequent victims of sex slavery and the sex trade. They suffer sexual assault more frequently. They are, of course, the only gender.
They don't suffer sexual assault more frequently. I don't know about the sex trade.
It's 80-20. Those are the crime statistics. It's 80-20.
No, it's
yes,
not.
Yes, it is. Oh, God. You realize
I'm going to post the source again. You're wrong yet again.
You're arguing with someone who was a criminal defense attorney for years on statistics about
that doesn't make you right. Arguments from authority, I don't appreciate it. Logical fallacies seem your best suit. So I guess keep throwing them out.
So your whole strategy is to keep calling things logical fallacies that aren't fallacies.
Keep putting them. Red herrings, straw men, ad hominems. I mean, dude, are you going to do all of them in one debate?
Again,
I'm impressed.
Your whole argument is a straw man because you refuse to concede that feminism is feminism. Like you're arguing against something that you've made up. Now let's go back to something else you made up.
No, I'm saying feminism.
You said that men are keeping themselves enslaved. What in the heck are you talking about? There is no country in the world where men have inferior rights to women, especially not the United States of America.
United States.
That's not true. That's simply not true.
Yes, it is. All right. Do men have reproductive rights?
Yes. We have free access to contraception that works for our particular junk. Women have to have permission.
Okay, let's say that a woman gets pregnant. Let's say that a woman gets pregnant. Who has the rights over that? If a woman has a kid, is the man responsible, even if he said he didn't want it and he wanted to get rid of it? Is the man still responsible financially? Yes or no?
Yes.
When a man is tied to a financial burden that he did not want, that is not reproductive rights. Just like when they force a woman to have a child because they don't think that abortion is okay. She is tied to her reproductive rights. Men are tied to the financial restraint or the financial strain of having to support a child they didn't want. So that is not reproductive rights.
Condoms.
There are countries, I believe it's Sweden, that has something called a legal abortion.
Condoms.
Where if a woman decides decides to have a child, then they
have
a legal abortion.
You don't have to come in there. All right.
We should just throw away. Okay, so women shouldn't be allowed to have abortions because they have more birth control options than men do. Right?
We can have that debate another time because we might actually find agreement.
No. Answer my question. You want to keep throwing out the condoms, bro, thing. Women shouldn't be able to have abortions then by your logic because they have far more options than our fucking condom choices.
Women
are fucking lazy when it comes to taking birth control.
Oh, wow.
And the fact that, you're saying
my wife just had to have an IUD removed surgically that she got in to be part of our reproductive decisions. She had to be put under and she had to basically undergo an unwelcome assault on her body.
Was it her choice to put it in or not?
It was. She made that choice and she made sacrifice for our family.
Okay, wow. Congratulations to her for taking responsibility for her body.
Now, I don't want to ignore what you're saying about abortion What I want to say is we might find common ground on that, and it still has nothing really to do with your point, because we have...
Well, you brought up the condom thing. I'm saying men do not have reproductive rights, because if a woman gets pregnant, let's say a condom
you
breaks...
You can keep a woman from getting pregnant.
Let's say a condom breaks and the woman gets pregnant and the man says from the beginning, that's why I wore a fucking condom, I don't want to have a kid. And she says, fuck you, I'm having the kid and you're going to fucking pay for it. What is he able to do in our society about
that? Should have pulled out.
Jack shit. Oh, he wore the condom though.
Should have pulled out.
That's what you said. Condom.
You got to be 100%.
Oh, so he should pull out while he's wearing a condom. Yeah. Okay, so men have to worry so much about their own reproduction that they have to pull out, because they're worried about a woman taking advantage of them.
That's pretty fucked up
that we live in a society where men have to worry about that.
You're relying on the fundamental assumption that child support is supposed to benefit women. It's not supposed to benefit the child.
It is supposed to benefit women, and only does support women.
Doesn't.
Name one way that it supports men then. Okay, how does it support men when men are paying all this money to kids they don't want?
You realize that half of all babies born are boys, right?
Okay, again, how is that relevant to a man who doesn't want his child?
How is that relevant to the needs of the boy who will be a man who needs to be taken care of?
Okay, I thought we lived in an equal society where women can work just as much as men can.
No, we don't in that respect.
We don't? Oh, well, shit. I didn't know that.
And it's because we don't have the kind of child care.
My mom's the breadwinner in my house. It's surprising to me that women can't find jobs to make money.
Really?
It sounds like...
You've been trying to find jobs with kids lately.
Women choose to work jobs that earn less money.
That's simply not true.
Women also work less hours. It is objectively
true. You're setting up the straw man of the child support queen sitting at home that doesn't match the vast majority.
Because that happens. Do you know how many fucking people I've met that have faced that in their own life?
Do you know how many people I've met with
there are countless numbers of men that I have met that have been burdened with child support for a kid they did not want or did not know about.
They didn't have to take on that burden.
Oh, yeah, they do. Yeah, they do. They go to jail if they don't.
No.
Yes.
They could have pulled out.
Okay. How did they get out?
They could have pulled out.
So they don't have reproductive rights once a woman gets pregnant.
Right.
How do you know? Okay, so how do you know your condom's going to break?
You know, that's why you pull out too.
So you pull out every single time you have sex?
Well, I don't, but I'm married.
Okay, my point is that women have reproductive rights.
So do
women.
Men.
No, they do not.
Yes, they do. They have. We have greater access to birth control that works for us.
To condoms.
Yeah.
That's it. That's all
we
have.
That's all we need.
Women have birth control. Yeah. Women have
IUD. Women have to do things women that change their body chemistry.
The female condom? Oh, poor them. If there was something that I could take that would prevent me from getting a woman pregnant, and it changed my body chemistry a little bit, I'd take it in a fucking heartbeat.
Well, good for you.
Instead of bitching.
And we're working on that right now. And then that part of your argument.
We actually have one in India that's 99.9% effective, and yet the FDA won't approve it.
Yeah.
So there's already ones that exist, but they won't allow them to come in for some reason.
Well.
But my point still stands that men do not have reproductive rights, whereas women
do. Men have reproductive rights.
Because if a woman gets pregnant, she can abort the child. If a woman is pregnant, he can't do about it because it's her body.
Could have done shit before.
And I've actually been the person, I've actually personally experienced where I've got someone pregnant.
Oh, I didn't here we know go. About it. Now we get to the root of the issue. Poor little anti-feminist is tired of having to take care of his child. Oh,
condescension is great. I love it.
It all makes sense.
Actually,
now.
That's.
Oh, you poor thing.
You seem very good at assuming before I even finish. The girl aborted my child without my permission or me knowing, without telling me about it, without me even knowing she was pregnant, she had an abortion.
Yep. It's her body. I'm sorry. That's the law in this country.
The fact that you think this is such a topic for, I mean, what if I actually had a child who someone was extorting me?
It's not extortion.
Child support. Oh, it is extortion. If I didn't want the child and I let her know that before we had sex, then yeah, it's extortion.
If you were able to demonstrate to a court that you were the superior parent for a child, you'd be the one receiving child support.
Oh yeah, good luck. Women don't pay child support. Men pay child support far more often than women
do.
Women who have to pay child support just pretty much don't.
And there is objective truth to that. And I've seen that.
Yeah, there is, as well as everything else I stated.
But the law is not written to favor women. It's just how it is. Just like
it is written to favor women.
The statutes, the child support statutes that are on the books right now are explicitly gender neutral. In Tennessee, our child visitation statute specifically says that child custody agreements should give maximum parenting time to both parents. The law is trying to hit this issue, but here's where I'm going with this. The law is written in an egalitarian way. We still don't have egalitarian outcomes, and you're upset about the lack of equal outcomes. And that's legitimate.
No, I'm not upset about that. I'm upset that men do not have reproductive rights.
We've already
Is reproductive rights. That is not reproductive rights.
It's superior.
Because I cannot control. No, because condoms break.
Condoms have.
More often than birth control fails. And women have multiple different options for birth control to match them. Men have condoms, and that's it.
All right. Well, let's get back to feminism.
That's like saying I have a right to life if I live in a war zone by wearing a bulletproof vest. The logic is just fundamentally flawed, and
sounds
it's
like you're firing
mind-blowing that you can't.
Okay, but let's go back to go back to the value of feminism. Women have not always had access to those things. Birth control pills used to be illegal. IUDs are a relatively new invention. Feminists had to
fight. And we do all these things for women while doing nothing for ourselves.
Feminists had to fight to get those rights. Without feminism, those rights might go away. There are legislatures in this country that have tried to place restrictions on women's access to these kinds of birth control. It's feminists today who are fighting back against those efforts to keep.
I don't know any even Republicans who are trying to fight for women to not have birth control. Yeah. I do know people who are trying to defund Planned Parenthood because the fact that we're funding with tax dollars abortion to me is appalling. That should not
be Republicans. We pay for with Republicans our money. Took President Obama to the Supreme Court to try to get out of women having access to birth control. I mean, that's actually.
Are you talking about Planned Parenthood or birth control?
I'm talking about birth control. I'm talking about the parts of Obamacare that guarantee reproductive rights. Now,
you're talking about how they get it paid for by the government. Yeah, that's bullshit.
Oh, that's crap. No, they pay for it with their health insurance premiums, which come out of their paycheck.
Which get paid for by the government through Obamacare.
No. It would have affected all women, even ones who pay their premiums 100%. All right. So again, you're setting up this straw man of the woman who chooses not to work and relies on the government. It's not a true stereotype. You want to talk about equal pay?
It is.
You
want to
talk about equal pay for
true.
Equal work? I'm an attorney in my field today. In large law firms, even though more of the associates are women, 8 out of every 10 partners are still men. They don't have the same opportunities.
Again, equality of opportunity,
equality of opportunity because they're bringing in the same amount of business. They're making the same amount of money for the firm. It's demonstrable.
Then they should quit and start their own firm or work somewhere else. If that's honestly what you're saying is that
these people are women. But a man would not have to do that.
You know, I don't know a single business that I've ever been to where they're like, oh, you know, we have this person here who's making more money than everyone else. And the manager's like, what? I didn't know about this. Oh, well, because she has a vagina. Well, screw her. We don't want her. Businesses care about money and the bottom line. You're telling me that these businesses are not giving women promotions just because they have a vagina. That's bullshit.
I don't know the exact reason that they're not giving women the better positions.
Yeah, because you're assuming that it's sexism.
But if it is sexism, feminism is their address.
It isn't.
It's any of the other stuff you're talking about, whatever. But those aren't the demonstrable facts in the field of law.
The fact that they work less hours.
Female lawyers do not work less hours. They do not. In fact, most of the ones I know work more hours. Now, I want to get back to the most insane thing you said, which is saying that men keep themselves enslaved. I'm not a slave. You're not a slave. No man is enslaved by the idea that women should be equal.
The myth of male power. I would definitely recommend you reading this.
The opposite of slavery is not power. The opposite of slavery is just freedom. Men are free in this country. Now, there are women around the world.
They're not free because we don't have reproductive rights. I'm a slave to my reproduction. If I get a woman pregnant, I'm fucked.
Then keep it in your pants, dude. All right? That's an easy solution.
Oh, okay. So now I can't have sex because I don't have reproductive rights. That sounds a lot like oppression. You can't have sex because if you have sex, you have to essentially have a child. That sounds
I'm telling you, in
the same way men are being enslaved now. Men are being enslaved in a completely more diabolical way than women.
You don't even understand what the word slavery means. There is no government that is saying any of
these
things.
I never used the word. You did.
No, you did. In your first screed, you said men are keeping themselves enslaved, and you blame feminism for it.
Yeah, I didn't say that they're a victim of slavery. What? I said they're being enslaved. Those are two different words.
Enslaved and slavery?
Again, your grip on the English language
is tenuous at best. Your grip on reality is tenuous at best, and your grip on feminism is non-existent.
Thank you.